Welcome to Prophetic Rewind. So, this week, you know, it's been a week since New Year's, and we had a fantastic New Year's Eve broadcast. If you haven't seen it, go and watch it. This year, you know, we're focusing on the year 2018, the year of life, and so I've decided to give you a very special Prophetic Rewind this week. My dad in Israel in 2014, it's just a beautiful moment with him, very in keeping with what's happening in Israel right now, what's happening with the capital being moved to Jerusalem. And on New Year's Eve, we did a very special Code Breakers all about that, all about Jerusalem and how the United States has now moved its embassy to Jerusalem. And so in keeping with that, I wanted you to see my dad in Israel, and I found some really great footage. And it's from 2014, and just everything he says and everything that's going on is just so beautiful, and even him going to the wall and praying. So I really hope you enjoy this. I loved it. I was so blessed. I was so inspired. And I just wanted to look back, and I want you to look back with me at this beautiful moment with my father in Israel.
The Jewish state in our eternal capital, Jerusalem. I say that to all those who proclaim that the Jewish state has no roots in our region and that it will soon disappear. Throughout our history, the Jewish people have overcome all the tyrants who have sought our destruction. It's their ideologies that have been discarded by history. The people of Israel live on. We say in Hebrew, Am Yisrael Chai. And the Jewish state will live forever.
prophesy.
I am a paramedic from Magen David Adom. I was the first one to get to the scene from the security forces. Today at 8 o'clock, I heard the siren while I was driving the next street. I get out from the car and searching for a shelter. Then I heard the blasting. I look to my left and I saw the place that we're looking here, all in fire, something like 30 or 40 meters flames. I called the cops and the fire brigade. And when they arrived, we saw here something like 10 or 12 cars are going on fire. By very luck, the people that were here was getting out to a shelter, and this is the reason there was life was saved. These shelters could save a life because there is very, very little time to get to a shelter. So the more shelters it will be at the streets, this is the chance that many more lives will be saved.
I'm standing in Jerusalem. We've just got off the flight and there are things happening now, this very moment. Welcome everybody to Jerusalem. Behind me you can see the various mountains that surround Jerusalem. I'm reminded of Psalm 125, which speaks about the mountains that surround Jerusalem are like the Lord who covers and takes care of her. You know, I want you to know that God has protected this nation, the land of Israel, for thousands of years, preserved it to where the people came back, and now people don't even want them to be in existence. Their enemies don't want them to even be in existence. We know that what I'm smelling right now is just some of the smoke of a car bomb that just took place, and I'll show you image that I took outside of my hotel room, where you can see the smoke from a car bomb that just took place now. We can actually see, maybe you can even see it. We can smell it here. We weren't going to actually film from this balcony because there's so much smoke here. But I told the guys, you know, that the fact is, it's a reality. This is the reality that they want to kill and destroy this nation that God offered to us to give us a covenant, first covenant, through Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. Israel was formed, and then the last Adam who came, and that was the second and final covenant, which you and I understand. So I'm here now. We've just got off the flight, as I said, a little bit untidy. But the first images that you saw were some of the situations that are taking place this very moment and have just happened. the last few days. And the interview as well was done with by our team. Our team arrived and already they were had to go and under to a bomb shelter because of a scare. And it's not just paranoia. They're not like other countries where, you know, they think it might be something. When they say get to the bomb shelters, it means get there. We've already been told by security what we have to do, where we have to go when the sirens go off. Now, I'm not here to make a big story about us being here. God told me. This is what happened. I was praying not long ago, of course, 2 days ago, in fact. I was praying and in my garden, and I was praying for Israel because you can see on the news what's happening. Once again, they want war. Once again, Hamas wants to destroy the children, destroy destroy Israel. And they want to make a point. And so I was praying for them, and the Spirit of the Lord said to me, "What are you doing here, prophet?" Now, those were the words that I remember him saying to me. And I thought, okay, so what do you want me to do? You know, I have a ministry, I have family. Then the Spirit of the Lord, when I was preparing to go to the office and meet with everybody, he said to me, "What are you doing here, prophet?" You know, I was reminded of something that, you know, when were the prophets relevant? It wasn't during times of peace for Israel, but it was times of war, times of famine, times of trouble. That's where the prophets were necessary. And why would it be any different today? Why do we want to go when there's peace and there's harmony and where there's protection? And the Spirit of the Lord challenged me. He said, "I want you to get on a flight and I want you to be there tomorrow." Now think about it. You see on the news what's happening. We can smell it. We can hear it. We can feel it. The fear in people's eyes when you speak to them. The tension that exists here without a doubt. Bomb scares all the time. Running to shelters. We have given money to build shelters here. And we are here to protect. Now why do I say that? Because when the Lord spoke to me about it and said, "What are you doing here?" He reminded me of the prophet Elisha. When they ran out of water, when they were going to war, Israel, in a valley, the person that they found to help them was the prophet Elisha, who prophesied and said to them, listen to me, said to them, "This is what the Lord's going to do. This is how he's going to send it to you." And what happened was he gave a word that provided for them. Wherever the prophet is, there's provision. It's a fact. When Elisha stepped onto Mount Carmel after 3 years of famine, think about it. It was there that he heard the sound of abundance. He told the people, "Are you in two opinions? Are you in two minds? Are you going to serve the Lord your God?" And then he, of course, stood on Mount Carmel and prophesied. First he offered the offering, prophesied, and an abundance of rain came. The prophets were there when there was trouble. The prophets were there when there was anguish. So that the Lord challenged me and said, "Kim, I want you to go there. And I want you to stand and I want you to pray. I want you to proclaim. I want you to prophesy. I also want you to provide." In other words, we are here to help them. Not just with prayer, but to provide them with bomb shelters, food, whatever it takes. And you and I have that privilege. So we're going to bless Israel this weekend. We're going to bless Israel. We're going to go to the wall, and I'm going to take your prayers and your offerings, and we're going to give them to God at the wall. Something else the Lord reminded me about, and that was Jehoshaphat. You know, Jehoshaphat was a king, and you know the story. Three mighty nations came against him, and he was trembling and fearful, and he went and prayed, and his prayer was powerful. It was a prophet that came to him and said, "Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. You will not need to fight in this battle." And as I was praying about Israel today, you know, we're standing and we've just heard that they're about to go in and advance into war. And my prayer is that they will not need to fight in this battle. That's my prayer. Now, it may not happen, but it is my prayer. And so I'm standing here in the wind of Jerusalem. We just got for the flight. We look terrible, but just too bad. I'm a prophet. I'm here to prophesy, to proclaim. And you know what I've got in my arm is what I brought to Israel. Israel is forever. Yeah, I've got Conquer Mountain. This was done on the mountain in Israel, in Jerusalem. We've been on Mount Carmel. We've done a lot of work here, but we're here now to protect, pray, provide, proclaim, prophesy. That's what I'm going to be doing. Jehoshaphat heard these words from a prophet. You will not need to fight in this battle. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. They did that. And when the Lord sent ambushments against the enemy, it took Jehoshaphat and Israel 3 days to get the spoil from the enemy. 3 days. In other words, there again, the prophet prophesied. The battle was won, but not only that, they were provided for. There was a great provision that took place. And so, well, that's what's going to happen now. So we're going to go to the wall in a few minutes. And when we get there, you're going to feel something really, really special.
I hope you're enjoying these prophetic rewinds, these precious moments I found to share with you. Everything about my dad was about the future, destiny. And that's what we're doing when we carry the vision. So I hope you'll consider supporting us and helping us carry that vision. Now let's go back.
You can feel destiny. You can feel the word that has been prophesied in our presence. You know, it's just amazing to me that years ago this was spoken, and then God hastily says to me, get out, go to Israel now. You know, when I said it to Jane, she said, yes, that's good, you need to go. And she was going to come with me, and then she felt that she should be at the house. The reason I'm saying that is because, you know, people have fear. But Jane and I have been through so many valleys of darkness and death that we realize that God is our source of provision and strength. And so He is to you as well. You don't all have to be here, but you can be, and you are, by providing for Israel. And what we're going to do is, when I go to the garden, have your offering ready. This is not about taking money. This is about taking money as an offering and giving it to the people and providing for them. And I assure you, we have done that over and over and over again. And we will be doing it this weekend and this entire week, dedicated to blessing Israel. Take advantage of this, everybody. Now we're going to go to the wall. We're going to be sitting there speaking for a few minutes. And then I'm going to take your prayer request to the actual wall. And I'm going to pray for you there. And when I do that, I want you to give your offering, and then I'll take your prayer request that you've sent in and pray at the wall. And I want to say something to you as well. If you haven't sent your prayer request for me to take to the wall, it doesn't matter. Just stay there, and when I pray, put your prayer in. Or you can still do it now. All of it's coming, and I'm going to take the iPad there with all the requests and hold them up to God. And I tell you, something special is going to happen. Okay, so let's go to the wall right now.
I'm standing at the Wailing Wall, as you can see behind us. And, you know, there have been so many restrictions because of the attacks against Israel. Look, God told me to come here to the Wailing Wall. He told me to come to Israel. I'm here. While we've been filming, as you heard, a bomb has gone off. There's been gunshots. There's been a suicide bombing. I can go on and on and on. The fact of the matter is, I'm here, and I want to take your prayers to the Wailing Wall. But not only that, I want to take your prayers of blessing to the Wailing Wall as well. So we were restricted in bringing any cameras in here. We only were allowed to bring the small camera in, but it doesn't really matter. The fact is, every one of you watching, you know that Israel is being attacked. You know that even Lebanon is attacking Israel now. And the government has stated that no foreign aircraft or airline should come, or they're advising them not to come to fly into Israel. We flew in. We got in just a few hours ago, and I'm so happy that I'm actually here to be able to take these prayers to the wall. This is a week of blessing Israel. What does that mean? I'm standing at the place where Abraham offered up Isaac. God told him to, and he made the offering to God. Even though God told him to withhold, doesn't matter. The fact is that this is where that took place. And this is where I want to bring your offering. And I want us to say, look, I'm going to bless Israel from here. Is this about money? No. It's about your request and our blessing to Israel together, taking it to the wall. In other words, when I walk to that wall, I want you to go to that link below your screen that speaks of blessing Israel. And I want you to sow as I'm walking there. Because as I take your prayer requests, I'm going to do this. I'm going to take your prayers and your gifts and bless Israel. Now, I don't want you to hold back. Maybe you can only give $5. Maybe you can only just give a little bit. That doesn't matter. The fact is that you're blessing and I want to bless Israel. While, you know, when we came through customs, you know what they said to us? They said, are you crazy? Why would you be coming to Israel when everybody else is canceling? Why would you do that? I said, because God told me to, first of all, mostly because we've come to encourage and strengthen and speak life. And that's what I told you, to proclaim and to pray, to prophesy and provide. And that's what we're going to do. So I'm going to turn now. Before I do, I want you to prepare your offering, because we're going to take it to the wall. Now, it may be a little bit different to you in saying, well, Kim, you know, we are all our prayers. We're living this day and age now where we can do it like this. It's pointless me trying to carry a bunch of paper to the wall because they wouldn't allow it anyway. But I've got your prayer request here, and there's so many of you. You know, Joan Hammond says, I need prayer for my mind. I don't know if it's psychological or what it is, or dementia. I need a breakthrough. I've got them all written out here. You can see there they are. And there's so many that wrote in, which really touched me. But the most important thing is that you're putting your faith out. And while I go to that wall, connecting your faith with mine, that we can go and bless Israel and bring our prayer request there. I mean, look at that wall. People standing praying, calling out. Who knows what their needs are, what their crisis is. It may be something small to us, but maybe something huge to them. Whatever your need is, I want you to know God is able. And this is one of the things He told me to do. And you know, I will say this, if God told me to do something, then it's going to be very effective. It's going to do something for you. And so we're going to bless His. What does He say in His word? I will bless those who bless you. And that's what the promise is. Now, there's a blessing that God can give you as you bless Israel. So let's pray together. I'm going to take it with me, and we're going to pray at the wall. Now, I'm going to pray with you for you to decide how you want to do it. Just go to the link below the screen as I'm walking, but let's first pray. Father, I call to you today through Yeshua, the Lord God who is present, who came to this earth here, right here in Israel. And I pray, Lord God, that you would touch these wonderful people that are crying out to you. They want to bless Israel. Lord, I pray that you bring a blessing to them as well. Show them what they should give now as I walk. As they give, I pray that you take that as a blessing for Israel and then return and answer their prayers as I go to pray. And I thank you for doing it. Amen. You know what to do. If this is the first time, there's a link below your screen. You'll see it there. Go into it. Do your offering as I begin to walk now. And take this to that wall. Maybe it's symbolic, but I tell you what, your cries are coming before God right now. Your cries are coming before the Lord right now. As I stand here, I believe that God is able to do it. As I stand here, I pray that your presence would come upon each one of them and that you touch them and minister. And then now I take the blessing from each one of them to Israel in Jerusalem. Okay, everybody, let's go.
I really hope you enjoyed that teaching as much as I did. And I really hope that it spoke to you and ministered to you as much as it did to me. And I just want all of you to know how important you are to us here at the House of Destiny. You're a part of carrying the vision and the legacy of my father. And that is the passion of my heart, is to do that. And my dad labored for 40 years and he was doing what God instructed him to do. And this is God's work. So I really encourage you to be a part of not only being a member of the House of Destiny, but also supporting us as we carry the vision. And if you feel that God's telling you to give an offering, you know it's going to go to the right place. You know how to do it. It's very easy. When you do that, you are helping us to build on the foundation that my father laid. He did that at God's instruction, and he was obedient to God. And I'm so passionate about that. And I know you are too. And so you don't know how much you mean to us and your support. And we also have so many missions that you can give towards. All of that is helping to build a house. It's helping to build a house on the foundation my father laid. And so I just want you to all know how much you mean to us, and to thank you, and to remember that every Saturday and Wednesday, we're still here. And we're building the house, and we're continuing what my father began, and we're carrying the vision.